Okay, I'm now going to repeat the experiment using a zinc half cell rather than the magnesium half cell. Now, I probably ought to put a new salt bridge in there, but I'm going to be lazy and cheeky and try and get away without doing that. If I swap the magnesium half cell out and move the zinc half cell in, okay, and try connecting it up, we can see if there's any difference in the voltage that I get between these two half cells. And you can see there is. This one's 1.08. So there's a smaller difference between the zinc and the copper. And you might like to think about why that is and the relative positions of copper, zinc, and magnesium on the reactivity series. Now, this has been very interesting mucking about with these. And obviously, I could have a play about with lots of other different metals and see what different potential differences I could measure. But one of the things that we want to do as a chemist is sometimes not to have to do the experiments all the time and be able to use some other people's data to save us a lot of work. So I think fundamentally we're quite lazy. So what has been done to make things simpler for us is instead of comparing random pairs of things, each half cell has been compared against a reference standard. And that reference standard is taken to be hydrogen. So the way they're compared is by putting in, and I don't have one to hand because they're quite complicated to set up, would be to put in a hydrogen half cell in this position here. So I would have a beaker with some 1 molar H plus ions in it, so something like 1 molar hydrochloric acid, and then I would have to be putting in some hydrogen gas, and that would have to be at 1 atmosphere of pressure, and then obviously hydrogen gas doesn't conduct electricity, so that gives me a whole other problem. So I'd need to have something that was going to act as an interface to allow the electrons to flow between hydrogen gas and the H plus ions in the solution. So I'd probably use something like a piece of platinum wire, because I know platinum is extremely unreactive and it's therefore not going to interfere with any potential that my half cell could generate. But once I've done all of that, I could then connect that up to my setup here, and I could take a reading then for the potential difference of my half cell compared to hydrogen. And if the voltage came out as being something negative, that would tell me that this half cell was better at producing electrons than my hydrogen half cell. So effectively, it would be a better reducing agent. If my voltage came out as something positive, then that would tell me that my half cell that was compared to hydrogen would be trying to use up electrons and therefore an oxidizing agent and a better oxidizing agent than hydrogen is. So by having all that relative data, that allows me to make comparisons between half cells without necessarily even having to set up the experiment and do it at all. So if I have a look now at some boards that I've prepared, you can see all the half cells that I've used here today. So there's the magnesium half cell, the zinc half cell, and the copper half cell. And I've also got here some data, which is their what we call E naught values. So this is the voltages that they produced, the potential differences that they produced when they were compared with the standard hydrogen electrode. So magnesium here you can see is quite negative. So that tells me that my magnesium reaction here is very strongly trying to go in this direction, strongly trying to go in the direction that produces electrons. So it's trying to form Mg2 plus ions and trying to form 2 electrons, and it's much better at doing that backwards reaction than the hydrogen half cell is. The zinc also is a negative value, so that tells me again that zinc is quite a good reducing agent. It's quite good at doing that backwards reaction, at losing electrons, which something else would then have to gain, and it becomes Zn2+. But it's not as good at doing it as magnesium is. So magnesium is a better reducing agent. Zinc is still a good reducing agent, but not as good as magnesium. And copper, by contrast, has got a positive value here for its E naught value. So that tells me that in comparison to hydrogen, copper wants to do the forwards reaction. It wants to use up electrons, so it will be taking electrons from other things. That would mean it's behaving as an oxidizing agent and forming copper as a result. So these values end up being very powerful because we can make comparisons between different species about whether they're good reducing agents or oxidizing agents. And I can see magnesium and zinc are good reducing agents, but copper 2+ is quite a good oxidizing agent. and it means I can know all of that without actually having to get my hands dirty and do any real work.